Merhabalar, ben Sercan. Today, we are going to learn how to say hello and other words to greet people in Turkish. Probably, you already know the first word that I'm going to mention here. It is what I say at the beginning of every video. Merhaba. Merhaba. We use this word basically everywhere. When we see our friends or at work, or when we enter a store and want to say hi to people, we use this word. If you want to sound it nicer, you can simply add the plural suffix lar to it. Merhabalar. Merhabalar. If you say a little bit faster, it goes like this. Merhabalar. Merhabalar. We use merhaba and merhabalar when we meet people. We do not use these words when we leave. Another word that you can use is iyi günler. İyi günler. İyi günler. İyi günler. In this one, iyi means good. İyi. And gün means day. Gün. And ler is the plural suffix. It literally means good days. You can use this in general, in more formal situations. Of course, for example, when you enter a store and if you want to greet people over there, you can say iyi günler. Or when you're walking outside and you see somebody that you know or you do not know, you can use this as well. As you can understand, this is used during the day, not in the evening. Only during the day. İyi günler can also be used when you leave. For example, you're outside in the street and you see a friend of yours and you start the conversation with merhaba, and then you talk, then when you're about to leave, you can say iyi günler. Or if you want to sound more natural, you can even say hadi iyi günler, hadi iyi günler, and that will mean have a good day. Or you can also say güzel günler. Güzel günler, which means have a beautiful day, but only when you leave. You wouldn't say güzel günler when you meet somebody. In the mornings, you can say günaydın. Günaydın, which means good morning. In this one, gün means day, you already know that, and aydın means bright. In the afternoon, you can say tünaydın, tünaydın, which means good afternoon. But this is not common. You wouldn't really hear this that much. Instead, we say iyi günler during the afternoon. In the evenings, you can say iyi akşamlar, iyi akşamlar, which means good evening. Here again, iyi akşamlar can also be used when you leave. Let's say you visit a family for dinner. Well guys, this is very typical in Turkey. We visit one another at home in the evenings to eat food, snacks, to talk, or just to drink tea. Tea is important in Turkey. Very important. Çay. Çay, which means tea. Anyways, let's say you visit another family for dinner. When they open the door for you, you can simply greet with iyi akşamlar. And at the end, when you leave, you can say again iyi akşamlar, which in this case would mean have a good evening. Or it is even possible to say iyi geceler. İyi geceler, iyi geceler, which means have a good night. You wouldn't use iyi geceler, iyi geceler, to greet people at night. You would use iyi geceler, like I have just mentioned a second ago, or you can use it when somebody is really going to bed, then you can say iyi geceler to this person. Here, I would like to give a little hint about the pronunciation of iyi akşamlar. Just because iyi ends with a vowel and akşamlar begins with a vowel, you will hear from the Turkish natives like this. İyi akşamlar, iyi akşamlar, instead of iyi akşamlar. So, as I have already mentioned in the previous video for some other words, it is written as iyi akşamlar. But when you pronounce it, if you want to sound more natural, you will say iyi akşamlar, iyi akşamlar. There is another word that you can use to greet your close friends. Selam, selam, or selamlar, selamlar. You will not use these with strangers. It will sound really, really weird. You can even say selam millet, selam millet, when you are greeting a group of your friends. Millet actually means nation, people, society, as in Birleşmiş Milletler. Birleşmiş Milletler, which means United Nations. Millet. But here, when you say Selam Millet, it basically means Hi guys, hello everyone. This is used mostly by young people. Well, not by me in this case. And to say see you, you will say görüşürüz, görüşürüz. Well, it could be a little bit hard to pronounce this word because of the vowels it has. So let me pronounce it more slowly. Görüşürüz, görüşürüz, görüşürüz. So, as you see, my mouth is always open and round while pronouncing it. So get this as a hint from me. Let me do it once again. Please look at it carefully. Görüşürüz, görüşürüz. Or you can say görüşmek üzere, görüşmek üzere, görüşmek üzere. And you can add time to this. For example, see you on Monday. You will say pazartesi görüşürüz, pazartesi görüşürüz, or pazartesi görüşmek üzere, pazartesi görüşmek üzere. Another example, see you next week. Haftaya görüşürüz, haftaya görüşürüz. If I say faster, haftaya görüşürüz, or haftaya görüşmek üzere, haftaya görüşmek üzere. Again, if I say a little bit faster, haftaya görüşmek üzere. In addition, there are also these ones that you can use. Allah'a ısmarladık, Allah'a ısmarladık. In general, you will hear this like this way. Allah'a ısmarladık, Allah'a ısmarladık, from the Turkish natives. So don't get confused. This means goodbye. The person who is leaving would say this. Allah'a ısmarladık. For example, you make a visit to someone's home and when you leave, you will say Allah'a ısmarladık. Allah'a ısmarladık literally means we have left you to the care of God. Instead of this, you can also use hoşça kal, hoşça kal, or hoşça kalın, hoşça kalın, which literally means stay well. Hoşça kal is for informal use when you say it to your friends. Hoşça kalın is for formal use. Hoşça kalın is also used when you say it to a group of people. I mean, more than one person. And if you want to sound more natural, you can even say it like this. Haydi hoşça kal, or haydi hoşça kalın. And those who stay behind would reply to this with güle güle, güle güle, as their own goodbye to the visitors. Güle güle literally means go with a smile. Güle güle. Yes, it means go with a smile. I mean, sometimes when you think about the literal meanings of the things that we use daily, they are truly amazing. Well, if you don't want to use güle güle, you can also say bye bye. If you want to say welcome, in this case, that will be hoş geldiniz, hoş geldiniz, formally. You can also say hoş geldiniz to multiple people, or hoş geldin, hoş geldin, informally. Evimize hoş geldiniz, evimize hoş geldiniz. That will mean welcome to our house. Türkiye'ye hoş geldiniz, Türkiye'ye hoş geldiniz. Welcome to Turkey. Alright guys, that's it from me today. In the next video, we are going to learn how to introduce ourselves in Turkish. So stay tuned. If you have any questions or any recommendations for a better Turkish learning experience, please write them to me in the comments section. So, see you in the next video. Görüşmek üzere.